Hello, everybody. Today I'm in the DP College and I'm doing the last in the series about innovations in school. And I'm going to talk today about the work that's happening in the performing arts. And so here at the DP College, I'm having coffee with Benoit, who is the head of drama. And we're just going to talk about the things happening in the performing arts this year. So,
hi, Benoit. Richard.
Hi. So, how are you?
I'm all right, thank you very much.
That's good.
That's great. Thank you for having me.
No, it's lovely to speak to you. So, it'd be really good if you could tell us a little bit about what's happening in performing arts this year and some of the exciting projects that are planned.
Yeah, thanks. Actually, it's a great opportunity to start because we've just started to have drama, live drama again. It's been about 18 months that we have a dry spell of live events, so suddenly we started again. And at the end of last year, we kicked off with a great six play, Midsummer Night's Dream. We had a cast of about 40, and it's not possible sometimes to have 40 people on stage. So what we do at ISL and the way we work in the drama is to try to involve everybody. And that means that we look at a production from all aspects, and we manage to signpost all the profession in the world of theatre. So that could be acting, obviously, but it could be sound design, lighting, set, prop design. So we got all the students to work on one aspect that they really wanted to, that they were keen to develop. So we had kids building the set, painting the backdrop. We had kids rehearsing the words, performing. We had musicians as well. And that's how we sort of unwrapped the project, where every time we met, we could send off some kids to the design room, some of the kids were going to the music room, some of the kids were rehearsing, and eventually we got all that together, we put it all together, something just happened. And we had a play made by the student, created, thought about. We had students who designed the posters, did a bit of production. So it really is an opportunity for us to tell them that theatre at ISL is not just doing some acting. Often we say, oh, you're doing drama, so you're going to work on your confidence, that sort of thing.
I'm just going to interrupt because I just want to say, I thought that was the perfect example of personalised learning. Because what was really good about that is everybody had a part. Like, you took the Midsummer Night's Dream, you know, play that everybody knows, and got the students to work on it and find a way in for everybody. A really constructive way. I know you've even got an example there.
That's right. So personalized learning is really important because that's the essence of the project, really. It's that we can integrate everybody in anything if we think about it. And this young chap wanted to make a puppet. That's how, when we presented the project, it was, I'll make a puppet. And of course, it's a theatre project, it's not a puppet show, but we're like, yes, okay, make a puppet. And he made the puppet, actually, from start to finish. And this lovely puppet, which has a mask, so he brought this idea of the sort of the commedia, tragedia sort of thing, and it actually works. And we managed to put it in the story. And so the show opens with one of the cast playing with the puppet. So that's a way for this young person to feel that it belongs to the project, see his work featured, even though he did make it very clear he didn't want to be on stage or were not interested to play music. But we found a way to interest him throughout the project, and he had that feeling of completion. He was proud of it, and we were very equally proud of him as well.
I think that's really special, the way that you managed to get projects and find a way in for everybody. It's a really special thing, and we really love to watch it.
It's special. I was about to say it's special, but can be challenging because we also need to factor in the sort of cross or intercultural elements of our community. And choosing a text like Shakespeare and choosing to stick to the Shakespearean English as well can be challenging. It's challenging for me as well, coming from France. I had to learn how to read Shakespeare back in the time, and it's all, I know how it can be sometimes daunting, scary, and it feels like it's not for somebody like me, for example, or it's not for a young person from a culture where Shakespeare is not a household name. And so it's about bridging that sort of that fear.
You do a lot of clever adaptations, or you get the students do a lot of clever adaptations to reduce it to focusing on certain parts, play with the story, yeah. get little different ways in. Mm. Like I like the way in that performance you started with students telling a story, so you turned it into a fairy story,
mm-hmm.
With the fairy story elements, which also meant that other people could come in, and also had really good bits of music that just supported that fairy tale theme.
That's right, yes. I mean, it's performing arts, so the way we approach it is performing arts is it's a blend of theatre, of music, of dance, but we can't ignore as well design and visual art as well. So it's about really creating a piece of art where we channel the creativity, we focus on the performance and the experience of it. And each student can find a way to experience that sweet spot of creativity, of ingenuity, and that is really what gives that confidence. It's not just about projecting voice or feeling that they can do public speaking, which often is how we sort of market drama. No, it's to give them this sense of completion of I have been part of a project with a bunch of people, and that actually is for me what gives me sort of a pleasure in the work and the thrill in the spine, because when I see them sort of becoming a group, telling a story together, with all these voices, all these accents, all these different background and all that. At the end of the day, Shakespeare just becomes a pretext. And they do a bit of cultural learning, theatre study, that sort of thing, and it's great. They're learning about Midsummer, they know who that character is or why the play is relevant these days, but really it's also a way to bring them together. And so to a deeper level, we're looking at how we can solidify and gel our community, I think.
I think that brings us on nicely to talking about some of the other projects that are coming, because there's a lot coming.
There's a lot coming, yes, there's a lot coming, yes.
So, and it would be nice to hear some of the big projects that are around the corner.
Yeah, we've got our largest, I think, community event, which is the Festival of Lights, and later down the line in the year, we'll have a play that is an ongoing project based on the year we've had and the Beirut tragedy, the explosion in August 4th, 2020. So these are the two projects that are coming up. But the Festival of Light, I think it's really important to talk about that. It's across the whole school. It's the largest event that we have. We invite PYP and MYP parents over a few days. It's performance, it's food, drinks, it's a festival, really, isn't it?
It's worth saying. Sorry. Going to say that. No,
go ahead. I don't know what you're going to say. I'll have a sip of coffee.
No, I was going to say that's all been built around the Mal's journey, which has been the theme that's driving the way we're planning for celebration.
We have a thread. We have a thread, really, little a continuation of the project that we've started, which is to follow the steps of a Mal. And so our Festival of Light is more than just a response. I think it's we're trying to probably move and shift the students' perception of the refugee crisis from the place of empathy, which is the natural place to start with. And I think this is where art can really, sort of foster a sense of understanding. And so we are now going to be in a position where we're going to allow students to create more than just a response, but to create something inspired by the journey of Amal and that project, The Walk, by the Good Chance Theatre Company, which is phenomenal. It's this large-scale puppet that has been walking from Syria all the way to Europe. And so we kept the themes, which is about belonging, departure, home and welcome. And the backdrop of it is obviously the refugee crisis. And the fact that in Europe, especially, we've had thousands of migrants coming in on our shores in terrible conditions. And so we are in a strong position as artists, as art teacher, to allow students to understand beyond the sort of place of care and empathy that usually we have when we just look at these things and the next day we just look at something else. That we're going to be able to make them create something that hopefully will have a lasting effect in them, so that their perception is shifting and maybe their understanding of what it means to leave a country when you're a young 10-year-old refugee means. Because I think as well, in our international community, we all have this experience of moving home, packing our bags or our boxes and going to another place. But I think we don't know what it is to have to do that in 10 minutes and just having a backpack. And so the theme of belonging, for example, is really important. And the Grade 7 are going to be working on that specifically in their short performance, is to understand what really matters to us when we have to leave and what do we leave behind, what is ahead of us. These themes are important. So Amal inspired them to understand this. And another key important element about the Festival of Light, it's everything is devised by the students. So devised theatre, it's not just leaving the students by themselves. They are going to be facilitated into creating something, but we really want to encourage them to do the research, to choose the art form that they want to use to express themselves.
Which comes back to personalized learning, isn't it? It's about trying to fit students to make sure they're doing the thing that's really right for them.
Exactly, and it's not about telling them, you got to do that, and if you don't really like it, you might find out you will like it. That's another approach. It can work sometimes, but it's about trying to spending the time to find what a student can bring to a project and nurturing that. Because really, when we take time, 5-10 minutes, sometimes to just let students come in and let them express themselves, they sometimes start singing by themselves. They start doing things that are amazing. And if you ask them, can you sing? They might be a bit reticent, or they might. So it's taking the time to looking at them and seeing what they bring naturally. So that's the idea of nurturing their own creativity in a way.
Now I'm going to move you on now to the play, because the Festival of Lights is something that ISO does as a tradition, and we've got a really special year, but it's something that's embedded in the whole institutional history.
Years, I think it'll be the sixth year of ISO, that we have the Festival of Lights. Yeah.
But the play is really quite a special one-off event, isn't it?
Yes, the play is quite special. It's been about a year. Over a year that I've been working with this writer, Mark Wheeler, and we're adopting the type of theatre that is called documentary theatre, verbatim theatre, and it's based on collecting data, information from people.
I'm going to stop you there, so just so that the audience knows, that the school's actually working with a really well-known playwright. So it's a collaboration between the school and a very well-known playwright to produce a new piece.
I should start with that, yes, absolutely. The collaboration starts last year. Mark Wheeler is in fact, by default, the most performed playwright in the UK.
Yeah, he is.
because he works extensively with schools, and schools perform his plays, and he does a lot of theatre in education, so that makes his plays extremely well-known from drama students.
Yeah, some of them well-known have been performed outside.
Much Punch for Judy.
Too Much Punch for Judy is the most
absolutely
well-known.
And hopefully very soon, a play that we have a working title, so I will not reveal it yet, but this new piece of writing that is worked with this commission is, as I said earlier, a sort of a thread on the year that we've had, an account of the last year and a half, and in the middle, as a heart pulsing, is the Beirut tragedy, the explosion, and the effect it had on people who experienced it, the effect it had on people who knew somebody who experienced it, an effect it had on people who didn't know anybody who got that from the news. So it's a reflection on how we receive information, how information travels, and it's really relevant because, like I said, it's verbatim, it's documentary theatre. So we're collecting testimonies, we're collecting stories from real people, and those words end up being the scripts. And that's what happened. And the people that we've interviewed are students from school. We have students who were in Lebanon, in Beirut, on that day, and their words are in the play. We have a student who's a very good friend of one of that person, who was on the other end of a telephone when that happened. And so we have that sort of story happening. We've got a gallery owner who's reported us as well, how they experienced it in Lebanon, a photojournalist. And around that, we've got other students who had no idea what happened. We've got people who were very focused on trying to tackle the COVID crisis in the UK. We've got also reports from what the government was telling us. All that, put as a thread in context, is creating that play. The project is to work with a bunch of students across the school, DP students and MYP students. And we will present that work in a theater in Ealing as well. And we want to reach out as much as possible to the community, our community, but also the wider community. I think this is how our school can exemplify how we can work within our walls and reach out to the wider community. Because I think community is a big umbrella word. We have our community, we join in that ISL community, but we have to think about the impact we have around the world. We're in the IB school and we talk a lot about the impact in the greater world, how we prepare our students for later. And I think it's important that we also give them an experience of what work, a concrete experience of work is when it's taken out of the world.
And that's a responsibility that we have. One of the big things that we're focusing on, which is social impact learning, is seeing education not as a rehearsal, but as a time when students can be engaged now in real problems in a way that they're having impact and not something that you're preparing for later in life.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I think we're going to finish there because okay. I think that has been a...
Is that speak too much?
No. I think that's been a fantastic introduction to everything that's happening in the performing arts this year.
It's a lot of work, but it's very exciting.
Yes.
So thank you very much.
Thanks very much.
A nice coffee.
Yeah. Thank you. And thank you, everybody. See you next time.
Thank you.